robotics process automation, is it same as test automation? I'll pose the same question to you guys. What do you think as testers? Is it same? Similar? Okay. Anybody else has a different view?
I think robotics has got artificial intelligence touch also, I think. Automation is just one of the component of.
So is this automation same as test automation? Is my question.
Robotics process automation.
Yeah.
So robotic process, is robotic being used as an adjective?
Mm-hmm.
If it's used as an adjective, then any task that is repetitive is robotic.
Absolutely.
It doesn't require intelligence.
Absolutely. So that is the key to it. And test automation is a part of the entire robotics process automation framework. So this is something that we need to get right up front. Now, let's look at the RPA possibilities or the areas where you can actually go ahead and do a lot of automation. Areas where you have a lot of repetitive tasks. Tasks that can need to be done again and again. For example, in the context of this event, there is a process where you need to, you know, do a lot of social media broadcast from time to time. You know that such and such event is coming up on so and so date. So you go, you go and broadcast about the event. It's a repetitive task. Now, if there is somebody who's sitting manually and doing it, how many broadcasts can he actually do? There's a limit. So you put a machine, and you probably have a bot that will do the job for you. Very easy. Then again, in the same context, if you have some reports to be generated and analyzed. Now, the same event was held in last year, and during that we saw that there was a lot of information that was generated. That, you know, how many companies participated, how many participants were there. Now, again, if somebody has to manually sit and analyze all that, it is a humongous task. Last year, we did a huge campaign on Twitter, and AGA GTR 2016 was the trend last year. And I did the manual job of analyzing the tweets, and it took me 3 sleepless nights to get the entire data. Now, if we just used a bot or an algorithm in that case, in place of me, it would have been done in seconds. We've become smarter this year, and this year we are obviously using different platforms to analyze. So this is just one more thing. Then mass emails and extraction. So obviously when you are broadcasting an event of such a scale, you would send out mass mailers. And that is again something which can be automated. Right? Then you have data format conversions. Okay, so here again, you know, there are images and there is a lot of text. Okay, and we need format conversions from time to time. You need, you know, Word to PDF and PDF to PPT and so on and so forth. And instead of you doing it manually, you let the machine do it. Then any ERP transactions that you would have can easily be automated. And then, you know, process lists and file storage. This also is something that can be automated. Now coming to the big question. Since we are talking about RPA from a testing perspective, the obvious question that comes to mind is, what are the test possibilities? Now this is where I'm going to give you guys an opportunity to tell me, what would you do if you were to automate a repeated task? What are the possible options? If you're testing it, then how would you test for repeated tasks?
Automation.
What
would you do?
You can
write a script. What else?
Use the tool.
You can use a tool.
Yeah.
An utility or macro or something.
A utility or a macro or something. Great. For reporting and analysis, if you have to test this, How would you go about it? Okay. Ibana is one option. What else?
Tableau.
Correct. What about this?
You can use big data analytics tools.
Yeah. You can use a tool called Flume in combination with Hadoop for this, and it works very well and gives you good results. What about data format conversions? How do you test that? Anybody? Any idea?
I think we have got converted tools, right? I mean, normally.
But how do you test that the conversion is right? You can convert it using converted tools that we have seen that can be automated and you can convert and do it. What kind of tools? What testing tool would help you test for data format conversions? Can a macro do it? Can a script do it? Or do you think that there can be a tool such as Squish which can do it? Or maybe Rhinodex which can do it? Okay. How do you test for ERP transactions? Any SAP testers? So, any automation tool that you can use with?
We are not using an automation tool as of now.
So, how are you testing your ERP transactions?
More of manual testing as
well. Okay. But how much effort are you spending on manual testing?
Efforts are larger. We have planned to move into automation.
Into automation. What kind of tools are you evaluating?
Work software tunnel.
Sorry?
Work software
tunnel. Okay. Anything else? Any other tool? Yeah. What about this?
ELK stack or
can you be a little more loud, please?
ELK stack.
That can be one of the tools, yes. Okay, the point is that there are many more, probably they are not ringing a bell at the moment. But the thing is, there was a session, I think in the morning, where Tarun spoke about disruption and how it is changing our lives. And he spoke about, a CEO's perspective on how manual testers need to adapt to a perspective where they need to go from manual to automation. In my experience, I have seen that there is a lot of focus on UI automation and a lot of people think about or talk about Selenium and QTP, and they are still talking about those things. The idea behind this session is to open up your minds to start exploring more tools, because every day something or the other is getting automated. In the last 10 years, since 2007 till 2017, the manufacturing industry has seen a 58 to 60% increase in their productivity. And that is all achieved through process automation. People are talking about virtual workforce in the finance sector, which is a big deal. So the big question is, how do you test it? Do you have enough knowledge? Do you have enough skills in your repertoire to go ahead and test those changes that are happening? Or are we still stuck in the manual testing world? We cannot be, right? We have to have knowledge and we have to be able to test. Now, I'm going to give you a scenario. Okay, this picture is from an application that is developed by a company called Task International. Now, Task International is responsible for making radars and lidars for autonomous cars. For cars, basically. Okay, autonomous cars have been added to their list. Now, the latest of their devices can be seen on the BMW i8, which is one of the most fancy cars today. Now, what these people do is, they have this software, it's a screenshot from that software, where, you know, they simulate your road condition. For example, Mumbai-Pune expressway. They will simulate the entire Mumbai-Pune expressway. Okay, with the trees and the traffic and all the bumps and tunnels and everything. Okay, and in that real time, they will do a simulation. Now, this software is basically a precursor to give you all the reports that can be done before crash, after crash, during a crash and whatever, whatnot. Now, the big challenge was, okay, the software is built. Now, how do I test it? So, I pose the same question to you guys. Okay? This software is meant to run on Windows 10 and Windows 7. So, that's your environment. Okay? It is a desktop application. It is a desktop application. For data conversion or data format conversion, it uses MATLAB and Simulink. And yeah, that's it. So, what kind of an architecture would you have for automating this? And what would be the recommendation for a test automation tool? I'm the customer, I've given you the requirement. You need to ask questions to me. But that will only test UI for you. What about interactions with MATLAB? Will it test it? Okay, this software is, since nobody asked, but I'm still telling you, the software is built on using C#, okay. And uses some components from Qt framework. I was hoping that somebody would ask. Before I give you the solution, I'd like to tell you something. But yeah.
The purpose of
this software is to simulate road conditions to be able to test scenarios where it can lead to a probable crash or what can be done to avoid a crash or a failure in the middle of the road. What are the possibilities that can happen?
Car.
Yeah, vehicle, any vehicle, car, truck, wherever this sensors are being fit. Wherever these lidars and radars are going to be installed.
So when you actually, for the backend perspective, maybe whenever you are, this whole thing, right, your simulation. So for example, you're talking about normal condition. So maybe you divide it into a module where it's your road condition. So from the backend, whatever processing unit you have, you provide different test data to it and just make sure that it is giving you the...
Counter question on that. So, how will you derive your test data?
So, that will come from the requirements. For an example, when you are talking...
I gave you the requirements.
One of the possible answers is just actually put it physically there on the Mumbai-Pune Express and see the... It's not that you are causing accidents, right? They will naturally happen.
Yeah, very, very possible. This is definitely possible. But let me ask you, what is the cost associated with doing it live on Mumbai-Pune Expressway?
This is the use of
or do we need different simulation tools to understand the...
Now we are coming up with some questions. Do we need Yes, probably.
Yeah, so to understand, I mean, probably the speed of the vehicle, distance between the two vehicles.
So you are talking about certain properties, certain scenarios.
Feature.
That is where you get your test data from. Okay. So the reason behind, the purpose behind this, giving you this test scenario, is not to get the right answer from you guys. Definitely not. The purpose is to make you think. But in any situation, when you get a test requirement, especially in environments where you have a lot of such complex automation, robotics process automation involved, you have to ask a lot of questions to get to the depth of what you need to actually test. Do you recognize that? First, only when you know what needs to be tested and you know, and then you start thinking, okay, if I have to test this, then how will I go about it? So when you ask all these questions, all the 5 W's and the 1 H, once you ask those questions, once you have those answers, you will automatically be able to put together an architecture. You will then probably go for a tools analysis to do your, to come up with the best tool to suit your need. But the point is, are you thinking? I had to push a lot for you to ask me questions. So next time a customer gives you a requirement, ask questions. It's okay. Understand, please understand that the software world is getting more and more complex day by day. You will have a lot more challenging situations. So you should ask a lot of questions. You should get the test data extracted by the means of your questions. Now coming back to this piece, I will tell you what has been implemented with these customers, at this customer side. So I told you that, a lot of image and simulation is done, handled by MATLAB and Simulink. So obviously we need a test tool which is able to talk to MATLAB and Simulink. Plus, that test tool should also be capable of doing your UI testing, because there is a lot of UI components involved. So just having QTP or Simulink might not be the solution. They might just be able to test UI, but what about the other components? And remember, I also told you that there is a component which is working on Qt framework. Qt framework, for testing something with Qt framework, there are specialized testing tools available in the market. Tools such as Wish or Robotics, they are meant for that. They are paid tools, a little expensive. However, they handle those interactions very well. So probably when you analyze tools, you will consider those tools for your tools analysis to arrive at the right answer. So in this scenario, Ranodex was chosen because of its speed and because of its ability to handle Qt framework and UI very well. That was chosen. And there were many other tools which were in the frame when the architecture was being built. But we have seen challenges with Ranodex as well. People are getting around it. Now the software is getting more and more complex. We are adding a lot more situations, a lot more scenarios. I just gave you an example of Mumbai Pune Expressway. Do you think all across the entire stretch of road, the lane width remains constant? Or do we have constant number of lanes? No, right? That changes. So your road condition is changing. Your curves, are they all equal? No, their radius is not equal. Okay. So it is not equal length, or the curve is not equal. Then there are road bumps,
tolls
where there is possibility of a traffic jam happening. Tunnels. Then what happens during monsoons? Maybe one section of or one lane is completely closed. So these are all real-time scenarios which you have to think of and implement in the simulation. So you have to start thinking, okay, how do I test all this? So start asking questions. Start learning about newer tools. Discover, start reading about them. really open up your minds as testers. RPA is here and it will change the world in the next few years. Things will change. You heard about Oli from Tarun this morning. Oli is here already. You have the, you know, self-driving cars. You have autonomous bikes, which are there. You know about Google's project of autonomous bikes, right? That is already implemented. So the big question is, how do we test all of this? Start thinking and acting on it now. And on that note, I would like to close my presentation. Can I have any questions? Do I have any questions?
You have a ready-made list of some tools which can be used to test human processing kind of application.
Yes. So, in the commercial off-the-shelf software, Squish is one of the most popular options, which is able to test image comparison and image processing and all of that.
Squish.
Yeah. The scripting can be done using Python. Okay. So Python and Squish work very well, which makes it very flexible because of Python's flexibility. And then also Ramrex. Ramrex, of course, the scripting happens in C#. It's a little more Windows focused. And since the scenario that I spoke about was for Windows 7 and Windows 10, so Ramrex was a more popular choice there. So these are the two tools. On the open source side, you also have OpenHMI Tester, which the only drawback with OpenHMI Tester is the support. You know, because open source tools run on support. Yeah, so that's one drawback that we have. But yeah, I mean, these are the top three that I think of, but yeah, there are plenty more.
Thanks.